Well, with so many minutes or seconds to midnight, really, you know, if we take a landscape to a level where it's vulnerable to these extreme cycles, they'll inevitably happen. And we've got that now happening right across the world, and certainly right across Australia, for salinity problems and overzealous agricultural systems based on a principle that couldn't work in this climate. So all of those things are saying Australia will look like the Sahara Desert, no question. So we must immediately start to do something about this. My name is Peter Andrews, and I discovered some time ago, maybe over 40 years, that the Australian landscape had this amazing opportunity for humans to recognise what we'd done wrong and what we could do to remedy that. To me, the natural sequence farming is a recognition of the relationships between plants, water and the sunlight, and then the gravity which is controlling it. Simple components, plants, processes they execute, bringing about a function that made this landscape great. At the smallest picture, plants start around a water body, and then they manage the thermal heat from the sun into latent heat, which then brings rain, and so you get rainforests on the ridges, and feed from the top was so good that the fertility developed downstream, and the grass could take out forests as they got too old and died. It functions in a sequence, and what I do is very quickly say, if I could pick up a truckload of forest residue, put it on the top of a hill and manage water, the vegetation could create a pond, then a delta will form above it and the system is triggered by the application of water, a rain event. The example that this continent is definitely showing us is these three things. Slow the flow, let every plant grow, and you've got to watch where the animals go. Obviously, if you're going to not filter the water, it's going to rush away and carry all your assets away. So you slow the flow. The only way you can do that is with plants, really. So you let all plants grow. That's going to do the second job that you need. And the animals who interfere with that disrupt the plants, so you've got to watch where the animals go. It's a very big mission, and it's a great opportunity, and I just hope that the good people use common sense and don't deviate. I suppose the biggest challenge is deceit and greed, you know. And of course, it's not really the way this works. I try to say to people, if you've got a pie that's shrinking, some are going to miss out. If this landscape was understood, it would continually grow the pie, and everyone could be part of that growth. So then everybody could be part of the pie. And I have a sort of tentative understanding that we will all work together and get the result that's possible, which I believe will be even better than the way the old landscape used to work. So everyone today, if we grew a plant, become part of Team Australia, we could sort of save the world from an environmental disaster. And it's known, it's publicised, it now has to be acted on.